Konnichiwa. We would like to present a brief statement describing a manuscript, a newly developed continuous zoom endocytoscope. My name is Youichi Kumagai, Associate Professor of Department of Surgery, Saitama Medical Center, Saitama Medical University. And this is my co-worker, the leading pathologist, Kaiyo Takubo, from the Research Team for Geriatric Pathology, Tokyo Metropolitan Institute of Gerontology.
I'm Dr. Kaiyo Takubo.
The endocytoscopy system, or ECS, employs an ultra-high magnification endoscope that allows in vivo observation of surface epithelial cells in real time after vital staining using toluidine blue or methylene blue. First-generation ECS was developed in 2003 as a probe that can pass through the instrument channel of the thick mother endoscope. Since then, four ECS prototypes have been developed by Olympus Medical Systems to solve the respective problems of the various prototypes. Using ECS, we have observed and described in detail the cell morphology of the normal esophageal mucosa and various esophageal regions, as well as the surface cell morphology of the gastric and duodenal regions. The latest prototype ECS, the GIFY0074, was developed in 2015. In this paper, we report for the first time our experience of using this latest ECS. As you will learn from our paper, this endoscope allows high-resolution observation and a high-vision view and offers continuous optical zooming up to 500 times. This ECS is excellent in terms of ease of use, ready access to regions, satisfactory resolution, and endoscopic durability, with further potential for use in screening.
It's very easy even for gastroenterologists to differentiate between cells of squamous cell carcinoma and normal surface epithelial cells using endocytoscopy. Here, normal cells appear on the left and carcinoma cells on the right. Gastroenterologists usually judge malignancy by the color, shape, size, and vascular pattern of lesions using conventional endoscopy, chromoendoscopy, and/or NBI with or without magnification, whereas endocytoscopy makes it possible to visualize the shape and the size of cells and the nuclei themselves. Therefore, endocytoscopic images make it possible to establish a final diagnosis. In the future, endocytoscopic diagnosis may replace conventional diagnosis based on histologic biopsy from squamous tissues, enabling pathologists to apply endocytoscopy to morphologic diagnosis via telepathology systems. After endocytoscopy-based diagnosis, simultaneous endocytoscopic therapy, EMR or ESD, may be possible. Endocytoscopy can reduce the need for or may even replace histopathologic biopsy examination for diagnosis of esophageal squamous cell carcinoma. These developments and conclusions have been reported in detail in several previous papers and book as detailed here.
In terms of medical economics, ECS will help to cut costs by allowing histologic examinations to be omitted. We believe that this will herald a new era of endoscopic and histologic diagnosis, and that the commercial release of ECS is justified. Thank you very much.